What's up, guys? I'm having a little technical difficulty, but we got some breaking news coming up. Some breaking news coming up on Harold Landry. Trying to get my computer up and running here. It just went down right before I was going on the air. So give me a couple of minutes. If you guys can hear me, go ahead and drop some comments in the comments section. To let me know that you guys can hear me okay. But I mean, just absolutely insane breaking news what's going on right now. Crazy time for my computer to lose its mind, but give me one moment. I'm trying to get logged in here on my computer and see if we can get this show rolling. Check, 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 check. All right, let's see here. Okay. Let's see. Right. Try to get a little bit better connection, guys. Hold on one sec. Get up. Self to stream. All right, check, check. All right, one moment, guys. We got some breaking news. Kind of ruined my intro here, but we'll get this going here in just a second. Appreciate you guys, persons. Y'all can still hear me, right? Hopefully I'm still connected. Hopefully you guys can still hear me. Sound clear. All right, perfect. All right, one sec. Let's see, let's get this going here. We'll share screen. Okay. Boom. Boom. All right. Cool, 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 cool. All right, gentlemen. Well, my intro kind of got messed up there a little bit, but we got some breaking news. We started the show. We're going to talk about Harold Landry and how he did not get signed to the free agent tag today. But some breaking news coming up here. Just a second. If I can get to it, I'm going to share it with you guys. There we go. The breaking news, Adam Schefter just reported that Harold Landry has signed with the Tennessee Titans a 5-year, $87 million deal to stay with the Tennessee Titans. 5 years, $87 million, $52.5 million guaranteed, $52.5 million guaranteed. So Adam Schefter just broke that news. As I was going on the air, I was trying to get everything aligned, and then my internet went down all of a sudden. So I don't know if Russia has something to do with that or what's going on. But anyway, exciting news for the Tennessee Titans. I got my boy. I'm going to go ahead and bring him in right now. The Blue Enforcer. He's live in Memphis at the Grizzlies game. So we're going to go ahead and get him brought into the action. Man, Chris, your initial thoughts on hearing this, that the Tennessee Titans have signed Harold Landry to a 5-year deal. Hopefully you can hear me and I'll see if I can hear you. I think you're muted, Chris. Chris, I think you're on mute. Let me see if I can get Chris in here. All right. I don't know why you're muted. Can't unmute. Okay, unmute yourself, Chris, because you're muted on your side, not on my side. All right, so while Chris tries to get himself situated there, thank you guys for being patient in the chat. Wow. Incredible. All right, there goes Chris, the Blue Enforcer. He's live in Memphis at FedEx Forum checking out his Grizzlies. We're going to try to get his initial thoughts. Your initial thoughts, Chris, on the signing of Harold Landry tonight after we thought he was going to walk in free agency.
Yeah, I think that's it's a big deal. I was definitely worried in regards to that. But, yeah, just saw it across the screen. He's going to be getting $17 million. About $17.5 billion a year, $52 million guaranteed. So I think this solidifies the defensive line, kind of keeps the defensive line together. Of course, they're definitely going to be picking up Big Jeff's fifth-year option. That's going to be about $10 million. So I'm glad they got it done. And so because when they did not put the franchise tag on, I was concerned. And obviously out here in the crowd, John Morant just hit a big shot. So his contract – this contract is massive. I'm glad they got it done. I'm glad they got it signed. And now we can try to fix up on the offense. So I was a little concerned about that, but they got it taken care of. So shout out to J-Rob. He silenced me a little bit.
Man, I had a whole show planned. I was going to go in hard on J-Rob here tonight. Like, man, you doing all that crying and stuff. You know, at the combine, talking about how this team is all in, and then one of your, a 25 years old, he'll be 26 in a couple of months, but you cannot let a 25-year-old stud outside linebacker hit the free agent market. And I'm just so glad that they were able to put things together, and I'm glad that they were able to put it together right before we went on the air tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's the thing is that, you know, when you have a big time, I've always said it, those premium four positions, quarterback, pass rusher, corner, tackle. When you have a good one, you don't let them walk. Big, nice, good pass rushers, they don't hit free agency. Because if he did hit free agency on Monday, he was as good as gone because somebody was going to offer more than like the $17 million that he wanted. So he got 17 and a half. He's the highest paid linebacker in the room. So I'm happy. You know, hate the fact that we maybe didn't get in on the Aaron Rodgers or the Russell Wilson sweepstakes, but that was a pretty nice haul. But, hey, Harold Landry back. I feel much better than I did.
Than he did a couple of hours ago. I'll go ahead and fill in the words for him. All right, Chris, man. Well, I appreciate you, bro. I'm not sure how much time you have. I don't want to make you miss the game. But, yeah, we're going to talk about Russell Wilson going to the Denver Broncos. We're going to talk about Aaron Rodgers re-signing with the Green Bay Packers. There's a lot of stuff going on around the NFL. We're going to try to hit a lot of it tonight. We know that you got your show coming up tomorrow night. And I will double dip. I will pop into your show tomorrow. Let everybody know what's going to be going on tomorrow night on your show.
Well, tomorrow night's show, I will give my thoughts on Aaron Rodgers and Russell Wilson on their moves. I was going to go in on J-Rob about not tagging Landry. I'm going to change that now to we got him paid. So that's something that we'll definitely talk about. And just a free agency preview as far as what the Titans could do as far as the free agency. They'll definitely have to get their money down, make a few moves to do that, and what they could look to improve in free agency before we get into the draft.
All right, good deal, good deal. So we'll get with Chris tomorrow night on his show. Let folks know, obviously they already know, but for those that may be tuning in that don't know, let them know where they can find your show tomorrow night and what time we'll be on tomorrow.
All right, 6 p.m. tomorrow night, live on YouTube, Titans of Truth tonight, about 6 p.m. Again, you can find me on YouTube at Titans in Truth. You can also find that official page on Facebook, the TNT Enforcers page on Facebook, on Twitter at TNT Blue Enforcer, and also on Instagram at Titans _in_truth. That's where you can find me everywhere. We'll go live 6 p.m. tomorrow. Again, we'll talk about the Aaron Rodgers re-signing, you know, highest paid player in NFL history. Russell Wilson going to the Broncos, and we will talk about this big deal with Harold Landry and what could be coming down the pipeline for the Tennessee Titans as free agency is about to begin.
All right, Chris, well, go enjoy your Grizzlies, man. We'll chat with you tomorrow. I'll be on this show. I'll pop in around 6:15, 6:30. But let's get back to the guys in the comment section. Have a good game, Chris. We appreciate you, bro.
Tighten up.
Tighten up. All right, guys. So we are back in the house. And again, in case you just joined in, breaking news tonight, the Titans re-signed Harold Landry to a five-year, $87.5 million deal. $52.5 million is guaranteed. That is more than the guaranteed money that Bud Dupree got last year. Bud Dupree signed an $88 million deal, but Bud Dupree only had $35 million guaranteed. And the reason why is because Bud Dupree was 28 years old when he signed that contract. Harold Landry is 3 years younger, so obviously he gets more guaranteed money, probably 3 years guaranteed out of this deal. So we definitely want to get to you guys' comments in the comments section. And again, thank you guys for being so patient. Errol Pierce in the house. Been missing you too, big buddy. Tighten up, man. Way to kick off things. All a struck. Hashtag all a struck. Absolutely. Titan Pratt in the house. What's going on, man? Hey, breaking news. We did not know this was going to happen at the start of the show tonight. Sin City's in the house. What's good? Landry in Nashville for a while. AJ Brown and Big Jeff are next. Yeah, those guys looking to get some big money this offseason as well. Let's see. Pardon me. We also got Titan Rob. What's up, everybody? These next couple of weeks going to be very interesting. Let's buckle up and let's tighten up for sure. Absolutely. And again, the thumbs up on the signing here tonight. And again, Errol Pierce, he got in after the signing, says, sweet. My boy Phillip in the house said he was prepared to go in on J-Rod too. He had a hashtag already and everything. Less tears, more deals. And I agree with you there, buddy. Less tears and more deals. And look, man, I had my graphics lined up tonight. You know, I had the my meme signed up for J-Rob. I had all of this ready for him tonight. But J-Rob came through for us. He got the deal done with Harold Landry here tonight. And so we're going to dive into all of this here tonight. Wow, what a way to start free agency for the Tennessee Titans. And it's going to be absolutely great. It's going to be absolutely great to see this guy. And we had a little theme music lined up for Harold Landry here tonight as well. So we'll let you guys get in on that. As Harold Landry, he secures the bag, and he's going to be making some money coming up for the rest of his career. This is a guy that's only made like $7 million so far in his career. Came in as a second round pick 4 years ago, and he's going to be doing it now. So congratulations to Harold Landry on the big deal. Now let's get to a little bit more of you guys' comments. Whew, I'm just trying to catch up, man. I'm just trying to catch up. Phillip. All right, yeah, we already got that comment there. Let's see, Titan Rob, does this mean LaJuan is most likely going to get cut or restructured? I would not expect Taylor LaJuan to get cut. I think he's still too important to this offensive line. We saw how important he was to this team when he was performing at a high level. And we don't have anybody to replace Taylor LaJuan at this point in time. We don't have a quality backup left tackle. Heck, we don't even have a good right tackle at this point. So we still got to solidify the right side of the offensive line. We're hoping that Dylan Redunks, he may come in. He may be the replacement for Quisenberry at the right tackle spot. Or Redunks may be the replacement for Roger Saffo if Roger Saffo is released. I think Roger Saffo is a bigger option to be released than Taylor Lewan, because you have to have a left tackle, and you hope that with a full year now since the ACL injury, Taylor Lewan had to spend all of last offseason just recovering from that injury. Now, a second summer away, you hope that he can get back to the Pro Bowl level that he was before. Now, they may ask him to restructure, take a little bit of a pay cut, but I would definitely expect to see Taylor Lewan on the roster in 2022. Devin had a question. Let's see here. Does that give us any money to spend on free agency players? I do not expect the Titans to be a big player in free agency with guys other than ourselves, because we need to sign AJ Brown. I think that's going to be imperative. I saw San Diego, I believe they signed Mike Williams, I think one of their receivers, to a 3-year, $60 million deal, $40 million guaranteed. So the going rate for wide receivers are going to be in that $20 million range. And then you also got to look at Jeffrey Simmons coming up. I don't know. I doubt if Jeff gets money this year, but we will pick up his 5th-year option, and we'll probably negotiate with him next offseason is what I would anticipate. Now, I would think, pardon me, guys, I do think we'll go after a tight end. It might be a lower level tight end, not because a couple of tight ends got the franchise tag today. I know Dallas put the franchise tag on their tight end. I think Miami put the franchise tag on their tight end. Makes me wonder why we didn't put the franchise tag on Jonnu Smith last year, but we won't go back and revisit history. But I would think that the Titans may go after a tight end and free agency, if anything. Let's see, Devin, did you see that Bobby Wagner got released? I did not see that. I know there were a lot of transactions that came down late in today, late in the afternoon while I was preparing for the show. So I did not see that Bobby Wagner got released. Wow, that is huge. Seattle is just really going. They're going into rebuild mode. So I don't think we need a Bobby Wagner. We got Zach Cunningham. I expect Zach Cunningham to be back. I'm not sure if Jayon Brown will be back or not, but we got David Long. We got Monty Rice that we drafted last year as well. I would expect him to be in that inside linebacker rotation. So with David Long, Monty Rice, and Zach Cunningham coming back, I would expect those guys to kind of be the big guys in that inside linebacker position. And of course, Rashad Evans. I would not expect Rashad Evans to return this year. Let's get a few housekeeping items out of the way while we get a chance, because again, the opening of the show got hijacked. So for those of you that are new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Everybody, please hit that like button. And also please click that notification bell. As breaking news happens throughout the off season, we're going to be hopping in live as quick as we can. This came down this afternoon that Harold Landry did not sign. And then all of a sudden, 5 minutes before the show, he signs the deal. So hit that notification bell, because you guys want to be aware of what happens when it happens, and we're going to bring it to you right here on Titans the Day After. And yes, the show is Titans the Day After. Tonight is the night after Harold Landry signs his big deal. Now, if you guys want to donate to the show, if you have a Venmo account, you can donate to the show at Kenneth-Moore-8667. That's at Kenneth-Moore-8667. If you want to donate to the show, you can also follow me on Twitter at KMoore Sports. We have a lot of breaking news that comes out on Twitter during this time of year, so make sure you're following at KMoore Sports as well. But the big news tonight, obviously, Harold Landry signing re-signing with the Tennessee Titans. And we got to give a lot of love to J-Rob. I mean, J-Rob, he had a lot of emotion at that press conference in Indianapolis, where he talked about how hurt he was at that playoff loss to the Cincinnati Bengals at home. And again, I was prepared to go in on him tonight because, man, I'm like, I don't want to see the tears. You know, I want to see these players stay. And the Titans right now go into the 2022 season with probably the best front four in football with Autry, Simmons, Landry, and Dupree. If Dupree can get back to 100%, that should be the best front four in football. Zach Cunningham is a Pro Bowl level inside linebacker. David Long, very underrated inside linebacker. Now, if we can get that secondary, the corner straight, Christian Fulton had a very nice year last year. We'll see if Caleb Farley, if he can come back from injury in his second year. Janoris Jenkins, he may be a cap casualty. I would not expect him to be back at the salary number that he's at, so he may be asked to take a pay cut. And then, of course, you got Amani Hooker and Kevin Byard, who are going to be stalwarts in that secondary. So I think from an all-around perspective, the Titans' defense is pretty much set, except for that one cornerback position opposite Christian Fulton. I think we're pretty much set on the defensive side of the ball. And so now it's time for J-Rob, I believe, to concentrate on the draft. You know, if we can get a speedy receiver to put opposite of AJ and Julio Jones, assuming Julio's going to be back. And then, of course, we do need a tight end, and we got to figure out the offensive line. I think the next big step for J-Rob is solidifying that offensive line so he can get Ryan Tannehill some more protection up front and open up some more running lanes for Derrick Henry in his return as well. So let's get back to a few more of you guys' comments. And, of course, we're going to talk about the big trade, Russell Wilson getting traded today, and Aaron Rodgers re-signing with Green Bay. So now the next quarterback on the clock is Deshaun Watson, and we'll touch on that a little bit as well with me being in Houston. There's some Deshaun Watson rumblings going on this week, so we'll touch on that in a little bit here as well. All right, let's get a couple of more comments in here, a couple of more questions. Al, did anyone get restructured to make room? Nothing's been reported yet. I haven't seen anything as of yet. I'll keep an eye out, and if something happens, I would. They talked about restructuring Derrick Henry. That may happen to try to get him a little bit more guaranteed money as he goes deeper into his contract extension. I don't think there's really anything they can do as far as Ryan Tannehill is concerned. But Taylor Lewan, Jackrabbit Jenkins, Roger Saffo, and Derrick Henry. Those would probably be the four guys that they try to get to do some restructuring to open up some more money. Quan B in the house. Thanks for joining, Quan. Hell went from rich to wealthy this evening. Man, I mean, you talk about, and that's a different level. You know, there's levels to this, as we talk about, and you go from making only $7.5 million in your career, and now you have a $52.5 million guarantee. Yeah, that young man is set. That is what they call generational wealth right there. And he deserves every penny of it because Harold Landry, and we talk about this a lot on Twitter during the season, this is a guy that consistently, every single Sunday, plays over 90% of the snaps. Every single Sunday, he plays over 90% of the snaps. He's a guy that doesn't miss ball games, and heck, he doesn't make misplays hardly. He's on running downs. He's on passing situations. He's in nickel coverage. He'll drop back in coverage from time to time. Now, what the one thing you hope is that this wasn't a career year, and then he gets the bag, and then he takes his foot off the pedal. But I don't think his character allows for that. He seems to be a very high character young man. So, and I would expect Harold Landry to continue to perform as long as he can stay healthy. Let's see, I think Philip had a comment. With Landry's big deal, AJ, Jeff coming down the pipeline, it feels certain this will be Tannehill's last year, and a rookie quarterback or second-year quarterback will be the starter in 2023. Well, right now, we really don't have another quarterback on the roster because Logan Woodside is also a free agent. Now, there's not going to be a lot of people clamoring for Logan Woodside, so there's a very good chance he'll be back as the backup quarterback. And I don't know if the Titans want to draft a quarterback this year because there's not a lot of good quarterbacks, even first-round quality quarterbacks. And I don't know if you want to – we don't have a second-round pick. So your first-round pick and your third-round pick are going to be very, very critical to add to the components of this ball club. Fourth, fifth, sixth round, at some point in there, in my opinion, you need to draft a kicker. I mean, we saw Cincinnati draft a kicker in the fifth round last year, and that kid was one of the best kickers in the league. I mean, he didn't miss a kick in the playoffs, and he was deadly from plus 50. So I would really like to see us invest in a kicker at, you know, late in the draft, fifth round, sixth round, some, you know, go try to find the best college kicker out there and try to bring him in. I just don't – now, I do like Bailey Zappe. I had a chance to cover him as a freshman. He started his college career here in Houston at Houston Baptist University before he transferred after the COVID season. So I think that's a young man that a lot of clubs are going to have their eye on as maybe, you know, maybe a third-round pick, maybe a fourth, fifth-round pick. But I don't think there's anybody late in the draft that you really want to waste a draft pick on thinking that they're going to be the starter in 22 or 23 or 24. I think at some point, but at some point the Titans are just going to have to probably next year when there's more quarterbacks available. And if you're drafting late, then you may be able to find one at the end of the first round next year. So we'll see how that all plays out. Let's see. OJ Howard. OJ Howard has really been a disappointment to me. Since coming out of Alabama, he was expected to be kind of the next big thing at the tight end position. But like we see with a lot of Alabama players, they get so worn out under Nick Saban in college because he pushes them so hard. Once they get to the NFL, they sometimes peak early. And I don't know. I mean, OJ Howard, I think, will be serviceable, but I don't see him as a big time player. But on his free agent market, he is athletic. He has some kind of Jared Cook, Jonnu Smith type qualities where he can run after the catch. Hooking up with Derrick Henry, his old college teammate, may inspire him to do better. So I would think about OJ Howard, but I would not expect him to come in and be a Pro Bowl level tight end. But we don't really need a Pro Bowl level tight end. We just need somebody that's more functional than what we had last year. See, Emmanuel Green in the house, Kyle Rudolph. Rudolph has been a very solid pro. He's kind of in that Swain, Ferkser kind of talent level. He's a little bit older now, so I don't know what kind of physical condition he's in. Now, I did hear that Rob Gronkowski may be an option for us. Obviously, Patriot system, knows Vrabel, knows John Robinson very well. I think he would come in and fit in very well in this system if he could stay healthy. Now, he may demand a little bit higher price tag than the Titans could afford. But I would definitely take a look at Rob Gronkowski. He's an excellent blocker. Now, you know he's going to miss 3 or 4 games a year. You got to have that built in. He's not going to play 17 games. So you're going to kind of have to monitor him like we monitored Julio Jones. And I don't know if the Titans want to go down that path again, but that's a guy to keep an eye out for. Rob Gronkowski, don't be surprised if there's a little chatter about him in the next couple of weeks. So we'll kind of see how that goes there. Let's see what else here. What else we got? All right, Sin City was in the house. Going to be good to see Landry and Dupree here for a while, man. Yeah. Going to be the next Rack and Morgan. I was never a big Morgan fan. I thought he was very overrated. I love Bronny Rakpo. I thought he came in and played well once he came in over from the Redskins. But Morgan never really panned out as a number one pick. He was always kind of a disappointment to me. So hopefully those guys perform a lot better than Morgan did during his time here in Tennessee. Now, obviously, there was a couple of more really, really big news items that happened today across the NFL, and we'll kind of touch in on those. Obviously, one of the big ones was Russell Wilson getting traded to the Denver Broncos. Now, personally, this one hurt my heart because those that know me know that next to Derrick Henry and the guys on the Titans, my next favorite player in the NFL is Russell Wilson. Always been a big fan. Seattle's kind of, you know, the second team I kind of follow in the NFC because of Russ. And if the Titans were in a position to trade Ryan Tannehill, I would almost rather have a Russell Wilson than Aaron Rodgers because he doesn't bring the drama with him. And Russ actually performs big in the playoffs when his team makes it to the playoffs. But ever since they lost the Legion of Boom, Pete Carroll has not done a good job rebuilding that team. I know Russ was not in for a rebuild, so he wanted to get somewhere where he and his lovely wife could be comfortable to try to extend his career. I was hoping it would be in Nashville. That would have been great. But unfortunately, Ryan Tannehill's contract was just an anchor on the Titans, so it's just unable to be moved at this point. So the next place for Russ was Denver. They wanted to stay somewhat close to the Los Angeles market. That was probably as close as they could get because obviously the Rams have their quarterback, the Chargers have their quarterback, Vegas has their quarterback, and Derek Carr. So the next closest stop to LA would be Denver. So it's good. It's going to be good for him, good for his wife, Sierra. Seattle got a lot of picks. They got 2 first-round picks, 2 second-round picks. They got a couple of players, Noah Fant, a big tight end, who's an excellent tight end. So I think he's going to be good for Seattle. But what does Seattle do now at quarterback? I mean, you got Drew Lock there. You got Geno Smith there. Now, they do have the 9th pick in the draft, so they could roll the dice on a quarterback. But Seattle is now in complete rebuild mode. And you look at that division that they're in with San Francisco, the Rams, and Arizona. I think Seattle, unfortunately for Seahawks fans, they're going to be at the bottom of that division for at least the next several years. And then obviously the other big news today was Aaron Rodgers re-signing with the Green Bay Packers. It was reported 4 years, $200 million with $153 guaranteed. Now Aaron Rodgers came back later in the day, confirmed that he is going back to Green Bay, but he says he has not signed the contract yet and the numbers aren't accurate as being reported on NFL Network and ESPN. But nevertheless, they'll be somewhere in that $50 million neighborhood, which is a nice neighborhood to be in if you can get it. So all the Aaron Rodgers rumors, yes, he's building a house in Nashville and yada, yada, yada. But the Titans, again, they just did not have the capital to go get an Aaron Rodgers. And seeing what Denver gave up for Russell Wilson, That's a lot. That's a lot. I would have given it up too, but that's a lot. And if they wanted a package from Tennessee, that package likely would have to have included a guy like Jeffrey Simmons. And I don't think any of us in Titan Nation want to give up on Jeffrey Simmons, who's probably a future Hall of Famer. So that's kind of where things are with Aaron Rodgers. And as I mentioned, there were a couple of tight ends today. They got tagged. Dallas tagged their tight end. Miami tagged their tight end. There were a few more signings around the NFL today as well. So we'll break those down. We'll break those down tomorrow as I'll join Titans in Truth on his show tomorrow night. And we'll have about 24 hours to digest everything that went down today. So again, if you guys have not yet hit that subscribe button, tighten up that like button for me. And then make sure you go subscribe Titans the day after. Let's get a few more comments in here before we get out of here tonight. L. Pierce said Denver gave up the farm. They gave up the farm, man. But Denver was all in on the quarterback. Now, I'm not as hot on Denver as a lot of people are. People say Denver may be the next Rams. All they need is a quarterback, and they'll be Super Bowl contenders. But you just look at that AFC West. And we'll talk about the AFC in general, because obviously that deal affects the Titans. That's another team that the Titans are going to have to now navigate through. That's another A-list quarterback that the Titans may have to deal with when it comes to the playoffs. When you're talking about Russell Wilson. So you're talking about Russell Wilson, Patrick Mahomes, Justin Herbert, and Derek Carr, all in the same division. That is a murderer's row in the AFC West. I mean, that is just insane to think about the competition in that particular division. And then that's not even mentioning Josh Allen in Buffalo, Joe Burrow in Cincinnati. Now, we don't know what's going to happen. And the good news about the Titans is that we're the best team in our division, and we should be the best team in our division going forward. We don't know what the Colts are going to do with Carson Wentz. We don't know where Deshaun Watson's going to end up. More than likely, I would anticipate Deshaun ending up in Carolina, because that's probably the next team that is really desperate for a quarterback, Carolina and Washington. So I would expect Deshaun to move to an NFC team. And then, of course, Jacksonville has Trevor Lawrence, who's a top pick in the draft. So at some point, Trevor Lawrence is going to come of age if they can get some good coaching in Jacksonville. So we'll see what happens there. But a lot of competition in the AFC for the Titans to navigate through. And we'll just have to see if J-Rob can come up with a succession plan for Ryan Tannehill at some point. There's a lot of talk about Mitch Trubisky now, not for the Titans, but Mitch Trubisky could be in play for a lot of these teams that are looking for a starting quarterback as well, the Carolinas, the Washingtons, maybe even Indianapolis if they move off of Carson Wentz. So Mitch Trubisky, apparently he did really well as the backup behind Josh Allen in Buffalo last year. So he has a lot of cachet right now. So keep your eye on Mitch Trubisky. Let's see here. Phil says, don't think you heard your thoughts on Tim Kelly. Since you live in Houston, is he a legitimate offensive mastermind or just a product of Watson and another buddy of Vrabel? Tim Kelly, I have nothing bad to say about Tim Kelly. Tim Kelly is a very good play designer. He did some good things with the Texans. Even once Deshaun wasn't there, he did some good things with Davis Mills this year. We saw some creativity. I mean, the Texans always give us fits. A lot of it is because of Deshaun. A lot of it is because of the play calling. So I like the addition of Tim Kelly. Now, can we at some point get out of bringing in ex-Texans? You guys know how I feel about that. But the last few ex-Texans we brought in have actually done a good job. Deontay Foreman was excellent for us. Obviously, Zach Cunningham in the few games that he was there was really, really good. So I think Tim Kelly will bring something to help Todd Downing and this offense next year, because this offense has to be more productive than what it was. Now, early in the year, I gave Tannehill and the offense a pass because he had a new offensive coordinator. He lost Corey Davis. He lost Jonnu Smith. He really lost his entire receiving core except for A.J. Brown. So for the first 8-9 games of the season, I was willing to give Ryan Tannehill a pass. Can't give him a pass for what happened at the end of the year. So hopefully Tim Kelly can come in with some creativity, open up that passing game. And what the Titans have to learn to do is get out in front of teams. Last year, we played from behind a lot. We rarely scored on the first possession. And most teams, their first 10 plays are scripted. So that should be your first drive of the game should be your easiest drive of the game. And so many times we saw the Titans go 3-and-out on the first possession. So hopefully Tim Kelly can come in and do some good things. I have some confidence that he'll be able to come in and help Downing. Divine appointment. Welcome to the show. Hit that subscribe button. I appreciate you joining. Insane what these guys get paid. Shaking your head. Well, think about this, Divine. Whenever these guys get paid, the owners make about 50 times that amount. So keep that in mind. These are billion-dollar corporations, these NFL teams. Billion dollars. So that little, you know, $52 million that Harold Landry is getting, that's just a drop in the bucket for old Amy. She won't miss it. She has that under her mattress. That's cool. My boy T.A. in the house. Huge. Yeah, breaking news, baby. Breaking news. Getting Harold Landry. That is huge for us. Came out right before we came on the show. So absolutely. And you guys go check out T.A. He always has a lot of great stuff going on. So make sure you go subscribe to him. I got to get you on the show, T.A. Next time we have some breaking news, inbox you and we're going to hook it up. Pig Wickle in the house. Been waiting on this. Now you can order his jersey. Yeah, you can go get your 58 jersey. He's going to be a Titan for a long time, for at least the next 3 years. And so you can feel very comfortable getting that jersey. So I got to give me some water. So definitely go ahead and buy that 58 jersey. I'm looking to get me a 98 jersey as soon as we lock up Jeffrey Simmons. So we definitely want to do that. William Young in the house. William, welcome to the show. Tighten up that like button. Hit that subscribe button. So does this mean the Titans won't draft a defensive lineman or edge in the first round? I would be fairly confident that the Titans won't be drafting a defensive lineman or an edge in the first round. Because remember, we still got Rashard Weaver, who didn't play much last year but showed some promise. So I expect Rashard Weaver to be a big part of that rotation next year. We also got Adeniyi as well. Now, he's a free agent, so someone may pick him up. He was only making $1 million last year, Adeniyi, but I think that was number 92. He really showed some flashes when he was in. So if we can bring him back with Rashard Weaver, Derek Roberson, I really like a lot out of Sam Houston here in the Houston area, but he's kind of fallen off the last couple of years. So I don't know if Derek Roberson will be back with the ball club next year. But Rashard Weaver, that's who you expect to be in that rotation next year of outside linebackers and edge rushers. I appreciate that, Al. Thank you very much on the sweatshirt. Appreciate that. Titan Raw, if Jordan Davis falls, J. Raw better draft him. Hey, we'll see what happens there in the draft. I know that's kind of more Titans and Truth, that's kind of his baby, the draft and the combine and all that kind of stuff. I don't keep up a whole lot with the college kids other than, you know, because I'm covering college football during the season. So I don't see it, get to see a lot of these guys live because I'm concentrating on my individual games. So we'll kind of see how that goes there. Let's see, Sin City. Drafting this year, again, in the first, I think offensive line, again, has to be a key component because our offensive line is very old. Oh, and we did not even talk about Ben Jones because Ben Jones is a free agent. So we may have to replace Ben Jones at center, another former ex-Texan who came over and has done a great job for the Titans the last 3 or 4 years. So I'm hoping that we can bring Ben Jones back if he wants to come back. I know he was banged up a lot last year, so I don't know if he wants to continue to play, if he's contemplating retirement. But you got your center position, and you got the left side of that offensive line, and Sapho and Lawan, who are getting up in age. They have higher salaries. And then on the right side, you got Nate Davis locked in at right guard. But then at right tackle, you still got that revolving door ever since Jack Conklin left. So I think offensive line, again, has to be a critical piece. Wide receiver has to be a critical piece. So first round, I would expect either wide receiver or offensive lineman. We don't have a second round pick. Third round, whatever we don't do in the first round, I would expect us to do in the second round, in the third round, excuse me. So I would think offensive lineman or wide receiver with the first and third round pick. And then after that, it's just kind of best available. Pig says, if we draft O-line or offensive weapon while receiver tight end in the first round, we trade back. You may trade back. The advantage to being in the first round is you get that fifth year option on a player. Now, if you can trade back and get an extra pick, that's great. But if there's a player there that you like, take that player. Last year, I was a big proponent of taking Elijah Moore at wide receiver. And we saw him really pop at the end of the year for the New York Jets. I was not a fan of the Caleb Farley pick because I just don't like drafting injured players, especially at a position where you have to run a lot like wide receiver or cornerback. It was okay for Jeffrey Simmons because he's an interior lineman, but I don't like drafting skill position players who already have a history of injury. So I did not like that Caleb Farley pick from the jump last year. So we'll see what happens there. Let's see, we'll get a couple of more comments in here. Juju Smith-Schuster. I think the Titans need a guy with speed. Juju, he's a good possession guy, but the Titans need a Tyreek Hill type, a guy that can really put fear in the defense because with Julio Jones' injury history, A.J. Brown has had some injury history, it's kind of affecting their deep downfield speed capabilities. So I'd really love, even Khalif Raymond, when Khalif Raymond was here, he was an excellent threat to stretch the ball downfield. So I think the Titans need a guy like that, and I think that's what they'll be looking for in a draft, a guy who can run some reverses, a guy that can be excellent on special teams as well, give them a threat, returning kicks, returning punts. So I would expect the Titans to look for a little bit more speed in this draft because their overall team speed is not really there. Even in the backfield, Derrick Henry's fast, but he's not fast, but he's fast. You know, Deontay Foreman, you know, he's a big lumbering guy. Hopefully we can bring him back. But we need a game changer, a guy where you can get it in his hands and boom, you know, like a Jamar Chase type. You know, you're looking for those guys that you can just throw it to him on a five-yard pass and then they can break one tackle and take it to the house. And that's what this offense has been missing, is the big play capability. Because it's hard to drive, you know, 10 plays, 75 yards against a lot of NFL defenses. So we'll see what happens there. There are a lot of free agent tight ends out there. OJ Howard, we talked about. A couple of them got tagged today. But there are quite a few free agents. Kyle Rudolph is out there. Jared Cook is out there. That guy's going to been playing forever. Started his career with the Titans when he sucked. And then he got good after he left. So, you know, maybe Jared Cook, you know, does a bookend, comes back and ends his career with the Titans. So, yeah, there are quite a few out there. Would you give up a first for DK Metcalf? No, not because of his talent, because just like A.J. Brown, he's going to demand big money next year. So you can't have two wide receivers making over $20 million a year. And that's where DK Metcalf is likely going to be next year, along with A.J. Brown. But I love to have both of those guys, yes. But the Titans need a young receiver on a rookie contract, because you got either this offseason, more than likely, or next offseason for sure, you're going to have to give A.J. Brown probably $20, $22 million a year. Probably like a four-year, $80 million deal for A.J. Brown. So you can't have two of those guys at the same position on your roster. So there you go. Well, bro, I appreciate you guys hopping in tonight. Thanks for sticking out through the first little craziness of the show. Again, we'll have a lot more stuff going on throughout the coming days, throughout the coming weeks, as we get deeper into free agency, we get closer to the draft, and all of the offseason shenanigans that are going to be going on around not only the Titans. If something happens with Deshaun Watson, if something happens with Carson Wentz, we will be on to talk about it, because obviously those teams are in our division and they're a direct threat to us. If there's something big going around the AFC, we'll definitely touch on that as well. Just to update on the Deshaun Watson, he is supposed to go to court on Friday, supposed to be in front of a grand jury where they're going to determine what the next steps are in that situation. So we'll see what happens with Deshaun. We'll probably start to get some answers on him, you know, late this week, early next week, onto what his legal situation will be and where he may be headed. So again, thank you guys for joining in tonight. We really appreciate it. And congratulations to Harold Landry on securing the bag. And on the way out, tighten up that like button, hit that notification bell, and make sure you subscribe to Titans the Day After. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Y'all have a good night. Talk about